A is tan inverse alpha by beta. A is tan inverse alpha by beta. That means tan A is alpha by beta. Take the triangle A. I am constructing the triangle. So this is A, this is alpha, this is beta. So this is root of alpha square plus beta square, right? This I am taking as capital A, angle A. This inverse I am taking capital B. Beta by alpha. So therefore, tan B is beta divided by alpha. I am constructing the triangle. So this is B, beta by alpha. That means root of, this is root of alpha square plus beta square. Alpha square plus beta square. Look at. So now this will become alpha cube by 2 into cosecant square A by 2 plus beta cube by 2 into secant square A B by 2. B by 2. Right? So now this cosecant square I am writing 1 by sine square. 2 sine square A by 2. This. So beta cube divided by 2 B cos square B by 2. I can write like this. Right? Now alpha cube divided by 2 sine square A by 2 means 1 minus cos A. Formula I told, 1 minus cos A is nothing but 2 sine square A by 2 plus beta cube divided by 2 cos square B by 2 is nothing but 1 plus cos B. 1 plus cos B. So 2 sine square A by 2 is 1 minus cos A. 2 cos square B by 2 is 1 plus cos B. Now I can replace cos A from here. Okay. Alpha cube divided by 1 minus cos A, if you look at here, beta divided by root of alpha square is beta square. This, right? Cos A is nothing but beta divided by root of A square plus B square. Now beta cube divided by 1 plus cos B. Cos B is nothing but alpha divided by root of alpha square plus beta square. Right? This. So equals to, look at this one. If you take the LCM, you will get alpha cube into root of alpha square plus beta square divided by root of alpha square plus beta square minus beta, this first term, plus this one, you will get beta cube into, if you take the LCM, root of alpha square plus beta square divided by root of alpha square plus beta square plus alpha. This you will get, right? This plus this. Now look at. Now this term is there. What I am doing is alpha cube into root of alpha square plus beta square. This term I am rationalizing. This term with plus I am multiplying root of alpha square plus beta. So rationalizing factor plus beta. If you multiply numerator and denominator with plus beta, denominator will become a square minus b square. Alpha square plus beta square minus beta square. That means you will get alpha square. Just I have multiplied numerator and denominator with this. Denominator will become a minus b into a plus b. A square minus b square means alpha square plus beta square minus beta square. That means you will get this one. Similarly, here with minus you multiply. That means beta cube into root of alpha square plus beta square into this with minus root of alpha square. Root of alpha square plus beta square. Beta square minus alpha. Divided by, I have multiplied with minus. Denominator will become a square minus b square. Alpha square plus beta square minus alpha square. So beta square will be remaining. Now look at here. Alpha square will get cancelled. One alpha will be remaining. Beta square will get cancelled. One beta will be remaining. Now take root of alpha square plus beta square common. Root of alpha square plus beta square common. You will get here alpha into root of alpha square plus beta square. Look at alpha into this plus alpha beta. Now here this I have taken common square. This I have taken common plus. Here you will get beta into, look at beta into root of alpha square plus beta square minus alpha beta. If you take this common, multiply with beta. Beta into this here. Beta into alpha here. Now if you look at here, alpha beta will get cancelled. Right? So here root of alpha square plus beta square common. In these two, root of alpha square plus beta square common. If you take common, root of alpha square plus beta square into root of alpha square plus beta square. That means root will get cancelled. So final simplified answer is alpha square plus beta square into alpha plus beta. This is the final simplified answer. Vishnu, you need a doubt. Vishnu, ఏంటమ్మా అడుగమ్మా ఆస్క్ యువర్ డౌట్ సో రైట్ టెల్ మీ ఐ హావ్ క్యాన్సిల్డ్ ఆల్ఫా స్క్వేర్ రైట్ లుక్ ఎట్ హియర్ This term you look at. Okay, now? This term you see. What I have done is, I have multiplied both numerator and denominator with rationalizing factor. Root of alpha square plus beta square plus beta. I have multiplied both numerator and denominator. Right? In the denominator, what it will be? Root of alpha square plus beta square minus beta into root of alpha square plus beta. That is a minus b into a plus b. A square minus b square. That means alpha square plus beta square minus beta square. You will get. Understood? We are right. This also multiply and divide with this one. Root of alpha square plus beta square minus alpha. Then here a plus b into a minus b. So alpha square plus beta square minus alpha square. That means beta square you will get. Understood? Okay. Okay. look at next application. Look at look at suppose it is given like this. Take one. Three by five. Suppose it is given like this. In the option, it is given like this. It is true or false, suppose. Right? A option, it is given like this. You have to check whether it is correct or not. Such type of things, what we will do is, suppose let us say this is equal to is there, right? You bring tan that side. 1 by 3 equal to tan of 1 by 2. Look at it. This is true means bring tan that side. If tan inverse bring that side means tan of this. Right? So this value, if you got 1 by 3, then this will be true. So this value you have to check whether it is 1 by 3 or not. Right? This value you know how to calculate. Take this as angle A. Look at it. Angle A equal to sine inverse 3 by 5. This sine inverse 3 by 5. So sine A is what? Sine A is what? 3 divided by 5. Sine A is 3 divided by 5. Construct the triangle A. 3 divided by 5. That means this is 4. So now RHS I am taking. So this is nothing but tan A by 2. That means tan A by 2 formula is what? Direct formula is there. I have told yesterday. 1 minus cos A divided by tan A by 2 formula is root of 1 minus cos A divided by 1 plus cos A. This value we will calculate. Cos A from here is what? 4 divided by 5. Divided by 1 plus 4 divided by 5. Right? So you will get, if you take the LCM, root of 1 by 9. That means what? 1 by 3. Look at, in the option it is given like this. If it is correct or not, you have to check means you bring the tan that side. You calculate this value. So you got what? 1 by 3. Therefore, this is true. Like that. Right? So just if inverse, if you bring that side, it will become tan. If you bring this side, then it will become inverse. If inverse is shifted to right hand side, it will become tan. Right? If tan is shifted, it will become tan inverse. If tan inverse is shifted, it will become tan. Like that. You can easily check. Like this, it will be difficult. If you bring this side, so you can check whether it is correct or not. 1 by 3. Like that you have to do. Especially in the multiple correct answers, it will be given A, B, C, D. Check whether it is true or not. So just bring this side like that. Look at next application. Look at. So he will ask like this. Look at. Tan inverse. Tan inverse 5 by 12. 5 by 12 plus sine inverse 24 divided by 25. Let us say it is given like this. This equals to cos inverse x. Then x equal to dash. Look at here. It is asked like this. That means sum of these two, you have to convert into cos inverse. For that, what I will do is, I will take this as angle A. Tan inverse. Take this angle A, 5 by 12. That means I will get tan A equal to 5 by 12. Construct the triangle. So this is A. Right? 5, 12, 13. So this is angle A. Right? Next, this take it as angle B. Take that as angle B. So angle B equal to sine inverse 24 divided by 25. That means sine B is nothing but 24 divided by 25. Construct the triangle. Sine means 24, this one, 25, this one. This one will be what? 7. Standard 24, 7, 25. Right angle triangle. Right? So this is the B angle triangle. Right? Now look at LHS. LHS is nothing but alpha A plus B. In which inverse trigonometric function you want? Cos inverse. So if in cos it is required, then write cos of A plus B. Because it is required in cos. That's why I am finding out what is cos of A plus B. This is cos A, cos B. I will find out this value. Cos A, cos B minus sin A, sin B. What is cos A from the triangle? 5 by 13 into. No. 12 by 13 into 7 by 25 minus 5 divided by 13 into 24 divided by 25. So this is the value. So this value, so this is how much? So LCM. So 325, this is 84 minus 120, right? So this you will get minus 36 divided by 325. Minus 36 divided by 325. I have found out this value. Therefore, A plus B is nothing but cos inverse. Cos bring that side, right? So A means what? A means tan inverse 5 by 12. Yes, B means what? What I have taken? B sine inverse. Equal to cos inverse minus 36 divided by 325. Therefore, x is what? X is minus 36 divided by 325. Like that, of these models, one inverse will be given, one inverse will be given. These both sum, he wants in cos inverse. Just simply you take angle A, you take angle B, right? So, what he is asking in cos inverse? So, LHS is what? A plus B. Whatever he is asking in cos, you calculate what is cos of A plus B. This is the one you got. Just by writing the formula from the triangle, you got minus 36 divided by 325. That is your answer. So, that means A plus B you got. Bring cos that side. Cos inverse this one. Right? A is what? This is the one A. Plus B is what? This is the one B. So, therefore, this is cos inverse minus 36 divided by 325. Therefore, x is that one. Like that. So, suppose if you ask in tan, you find tan of A plus B. Then you will get in tan. What is the answer? Whatever he is asking, you calculate that one. LHS. These models. Look at next problem. Look at next application. If look at the question. Cot inverse root of cos alpha minus tan inverse root of cos alpha equal to x, then sin x equals to, he is asking the options also I am giving, tan square alpha by 2, second option, cot square alpha by 2, third option, tan alpha, fourth option, cot alpha by 2. Look at this. So, this minus this is given x. He is asking sin x. Look at this problem. Right? So, this LHS, if you look at, here cot inverse x is there, minus tan inverse x is there. Cot inverse x is there, tan inverse x is there. Cot inverse I can convert it to tan inverse. I can convert cot inverse as cot inverse x, this is pi by 2 minus, what is the relation? Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x equal to pi by 2. Whenever cot inverse is there, I will convert into tan inverse like this. So, this first one, cot inverse x I have written as pi by 2 minus tan inverse x. This time, simplify. This. So now this is same. That means, therefore, pi by 2 minus 2 tan inverse root cos alpha equal to x. Now I need to calculate sin x. I am applying sin on both sides. Because I want sin x. So So I am applying sine on both sides. Sine of pi by 2 minus 2 tan inverse root cos alpha. So this is nothing but sine x. This is nothing but sine x. Now look at here. This is sine of pi by 2 minus theta. This completely is theta. Sine of pi by 2 minus theta. Therefore, cos theta. Cos 2 tan inverse root of cos alpha. This is sine x. Now look at here. This value I have to calculate. Now take this one LHS. Take LHS. This, now I want to calculate this value. This angle is there. Tan inverse root cos alpha equal to A I am taking. Equal to A I am taking. This is A, angle A. That means tan A is nothing but, tan A is nothing but root of cos alpha. Root of cos alpha. So therefore this is what? Cos 2A. Cos 2A. Tan A, you know. What is cos 2A formula? Multiple angle formula. 1 minus tan square A divided by. What is the formula? 1 plus tan square A, right? So 1 minus, this is the 1 minus tan square A cos alpha divided by 1 plus cos alpha, right? 1 minus cos alpha formula is what? 2 sine square alpha by 2. 2 sine square multiple angle formula divided by 2 cos square alpha by 2. So 2 cancel. So therefore sine square alpha by 2 divided by cos square alpha by 2. That means what is the answer? Tan square alpha by 2. So therefore this value I got, this value, LHS value I got tan square alpha by 2. Therefore what is the answer? Therefore sine x. Sine x equal to tan square alpha by 2. Tan square alpha by 2. First option is correct. First option is correct. Okay, next application. Next ones. Look at next application. Look at, I have told. This, look at, these are very important modes. Regularly he will ask in the exam. Exam point of view, whatever I am telling now, very important. This I have told, look at. X, when x belongs to, this I told. Minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2. This equation I told, look at. Sine inverse sine x is x. When x lies in this interval, when x lies in this interval, look at here. If x does not lie in the interval, suppose sine inverse sine of one angle is there. If x does not lie in the interval, what we are doing? We are converting that angle such that x will lie in this interval. X will lie in this interval. Look at, For any angle here, for any angle here, if you want to convert this, you have to do like this. Okay. This and this sine inverse sine x is there. Sine inverse sine x is there. You write this as sine inverse sine of 2n plus 1 pi minus x. This angle will convert from, how you will convert? Look at this sine x only. I will write like this. Look at sine of 2n plus 1 pi minus x. That means odd multiple of pi minus x. What is that? Sine of odd multiple of pi minus x is sine x only. So this sine x, I can write like this, such that sine x is same. This is also sine x, this is also sine x. Right? Suppose where n is integer. Suppose n equals 0. Means sine of pi minus x is what? Sine x. N equal to 1. Sine of 3 pi minus x is what? Sine x. That means this sine x we will modify. Such that this sine x only we will write it as sine of 2n plus 1 pi minus x, or you can write like this also, sine inverse sine of x minus 2n pi. Look at this is also sine x only. Look at this is n is integer. Suppose n equal to 1. N equal to 1. N equal to 1 means x minus 2 pi. Sine of x minus 2 pi. Take minus common. Right? Sine of minus theta is what? Sine of minus sine theta. Right? What is sine of 2 pi minus x? Fourth quadrant. That means sine x. So that means this is also what? Sine x only. Even if you write like this also, it is sine x only. We will write in one, in any of these methods, such that after writing this one, this we will observe. If it lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, then this will be the answer. After writing like this, you will observe this angle. If this angle lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, then this is x. Answer will be 2n plus 1 pi minus x. If you write like this, if it is between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, then this is x. Sine inverse sine x is what? X. That means this sine x will modify either odd multiple of pi minus x or x minus even multiple of pi. In these both, whichever is lying between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, that will be the answer. Look at, suppose for example, I will tell an example. This value we have to remember. So, this value minus 3.142 divided by 2. So minus pi by 2 means minus 3.142 divided by 2. That means this value x must always lie in this interval. Look at it. You have to remember this value minus 1.57 to 1.57. 1.57. Right? So x must lie in this interval minus 1.57 to 1.57. Look at an example, you will understand. After that, I will change the round. Look at an example. Suppose it is given like this. Look at sine inverse sine 10. Right? This is given like this. Not 10 degree. This is only 10. 10 degree means 10 degree only answer. This is only 10. right? This is 10. That means 10 radians this is. If 10 degree is there, it lies between this and this. 10 means 10 real value this is. This is minus 1.57 to 1.57, but this is 10. This is not equal to 10. This is not equal to 10. Because x must lie in this interval means minus 1.57 to 1.57. Right? So, what you have to do is, you have to try odd multiple of pi minus x. X is here what? 10. X is here what? 10. Here x is what? 10. You have to try odd multiple of pi minus 10 or 10 minus even multiple of pi. Right? You choose any value of n such that this value, whatever you are writing, that must lie between minus 1.57 to 1.57. Suppose I am trying. So this is 10 is there here. Pi is 3.142. Pi is 3.142. Right? First if I try pi minus 10. Pi minus 10. This is 3.147 minus 10. That value is what? Minus 7 something. That will not lie in that interval. This value, whatever you are picking up, that must lie in the interval minus 1.57 to 1.57. Now suppose if I am trying 3 pi minus 10. 3 pi minus 10. Suppose let us calculate this value. 3 pi minus 10. 3 pi minus 10 means 3 into 3.142 minus 10. So you will get this as minus, calculate, everybody calculate. Minus 0.574. You calculate this value. 3 pi minus 10, you calculate. You will get minus 0.574. That means 3 pi minus 10 value, this is this one. Is it lying between minus 1.57 to 1.57? Okay, correct. Pick up this one. Pick up this one. That means here what you have to write is sine inverse sine 10 is given. Just you write like this. Sine 10 you write like this. Sine 10 can be written this way. Look at sine of 3 pi minus 10 is also sine 10 only. Sine 10 value is same as sine of 3 pi minus 10. Sin 10 can be written as sin of 3 pi minus 10. Now observe this x. This is x. This is x now. Sin inverse sin x. X is lying where? X is lying between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 only. So therefore your answer will be, your answer for this is 3 pi minus 10. 3 pi minus 10. Just simple amount. Whenever sin inverse sin x is given, this 10 is not in that interval. How to modify is, you write some odd multiple of pi minus 10 or even multiple of, if this is not clicked, here 3 pi minus 10 I got. If I am not getting this one, I can try 10 minus 4 pi also. Right? Only one thing you will get. Either this or this. Right? First I have tried pi minus 10. Pi minus 10 difference is what? It will not lie in this interval. Next, I have tried 3 pi minus 10. 3 pi minus 10 value is what? This one, minus 0.574. That is lying in the interval. So, pick up this one. So, sin inverse sin 10 is there. This sin 10, you can write sin of odd multiple of pi minus 10. So, this 3 pi minus 10, this it is lying in the interval. Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. That's why sin inverse sin x is what? X. So you have to remember this one. You have to remember this one. Either 2n plus 1 pi minus x or x minus 2n pi. Odd multiple of pi minus x or x minus odd multiple of pi. Out of these two, only one thing will be your answer. Right? That you have to pick up. That you have to pick up. Now I got 3 pi minus 10. 3 pi minus 10, if I have chosen, this value is lying between that this and this. So that's why sin 10 I have written sin of 3 pi minus 10. Suppose take another example. Look at after this example I will clear the doubt. Sin inverse, let us say let us say sine inverse sine inverse sine 57. Look at, don't mistake with this degree. Sine 57 degree given means that is only answer. Right, sine 57 this is. Sine 57. Right, so you have to try 2n plus 1 pi minus 57. Which one you will get? Minus 57 or 57 minus 2n pi. Right? So, this or this. Look at, I will keep on checking which one will be correct. Right? So, 57 means simply close to 18. 18 pi means what? 18 into 3.142. Right? Choose the closest one. Right? So, if I am doing, suppose, let us say, which one you have to take, tell somebody, such that this or this must lie in the interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Anybody answer? 57 minus even multiple of pi, any even multiple of pi you take, or odd multiple of pi minus 57 you tell, such that that value, whatever you are telling, that must lie between minus 1.57 to 1.57. You tell the value. So, right, 57 minus 18 pi, right? Then, 57 minus 18 pi, if you calculate, you will get 57 minus 18 pi means 56.556 you will get. You will get 0.444. That means this 57 minus 18 pi value, this 0.444, it lies in the interval minus 1.57 to 1.57. Right, that means this I am writing sine inverse sine 57 equal to this. I can write like this, sine of 57 minus 18 pi. Look at sine of x minus 2n pi is also x, x is 57. 57, you can write sine 57 as sine of 57 minus 18 pi. Now, this is x now. This is x. X is lying where? Between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So, answer is this one. 57 minus 18 pi. That is the answer. Right? Whenever sine inverse sine x is there, 2n plus 1 pi, odd multiple of pi minus that value you check. Or that value minus even multiple of pi. Whatever you are getting the value between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, pick up that one. You write that sine inverse sine x as that one, sine of that one. Look it. I got 57 minus 18 pi. This is this one, that is between this one. That is between minus 1.57 to 1.57. I will choose this one and write sine inverse sine 57 equals to sine inverse sine of 57 minus 18 pi. Sine of this and sine 57 is same. That means now this is equal to this one. So this is x. This is x between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So that is the answer. So if any doubt is there, raise your hand immediately. Awesome. Don't waste time. చెప్పమ్మా.
రెండు రావు, ఒకటే వస్తుంది, యునిక్ వాల్యూ వస్తుంది, ఏదో ఒకటే వస్తుంది, నువ్వు ఇంకో ట్రై చేయి, రాదు. ఒకటే వస్తుందమ్మా, రెండోది రాదు. ఇంకా ఈ 57-18 పై కాకుండా ఇంకా ఏది తీసుకున్నా సరే మీకు అది -1.57 to 1.7 ఉండదు, ఓన్లీ ఒకటే వస్తుంది అంతే. ఐదర్ ఆడ్ మల్టిపుల్ ఆఫ్ పై మైనస్ ఎక్స్ అన్న వస్తుంది, లేకపోతే ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఈవెన్ మల్టిపుల్ ఆఫ్ పై అన్న వస్తుంది. బోత్ యూ వాంట్ గెట్. Look at next. This is sine inverse sine extra. This you have to remember. This point you have to remember. The model x you will get. Odd multiple of pi minus x or x minus even multiple of pi. That model if you remember, both you can try. Whatever you will get closest one that you pick up. Right? So you remember like this, right? You remember like this. For sine inverse sine x, this how to write. You remember this. Number of problems will be there on this model. Or you have to try these ones. Like this you remember. Next look at cos inverse cos pi. So you know that cos inverse cos x is x. When x belongs to 0, pi. When x belongs to 0, pi, that means x must lie in the interval 3.142. Till that it is allowed. 0 to 3.142. That means now look at here how to replace is cos x you can write like this. First one, cos inverse, you can write like 2n pi minus x. Look at cos inverse cos of 2n pi minus x is what? Cos x. This cos x, you can write like 2n pi minus x. Look at n equal to 1, 2 pi minus x is what? Cos x only. N equal to 4 pi minus x is what? Cos x only. Like that, you can write like that, or cos inverse, you can write like this, x minus 2n pi. So look at x minus 2n pi, take minus common, this is only, if you take minus common, 2n pi minus x, so this is also cos x, that means what you have to remember is, for cos inverse cos x, you have to try these two. Either 2n pi minus x, odd multiple of pi minus x, or in some cases x minus 2n pi. Both you have to try. Both you have to try. Only one thing you will get. Suppose take an example. Suppose cos inverse. Cos inverse cos 17. Suppose 17, this is not 17 degree. This is not equal to 17. This 17 is not lying between 0 to 3.142. This is not 17. So first blinder, that is if you are writing 17 by cancelling. Right? So now I have to try 17 minus 2n pi or 2n pi minus 17. Which one you will get between 0 to 3.142? So 17 means obviously it will be, we will try for 6 pi. So if you calculate here, 6 pi minus 17. 6 pi minus 17, that means 6 into 3.142 minus 17. You calculate this value. You will get 1.852. Calculate this value. 6 pi minus 17, right? Even multiple of pi minus 17. Right? This value you will get with 1.852. Is that lying between 0 to 3.142? Yes. right? So then you write this cos inverse cos 17 equals to cos inverse cos 6 pi minus 17. So this cos 17 you write like this, because cos of 6 pi minus 17 is also cos 17. Now this is x. Cos inverse cos x. This x value is what? 1.852. That is like in the interval 0 to pi. So your answer will be what? 6 pi minus 17.
That is your answer. Like that.
This model you have to try. Only one you will get. Only one only. You don't get any value other than this. You can try. You can try 17 minus 6 pi. You will get minus 1.8. Right? That you won't get between 0 to pi. Negative values are not there. Here, like that you have to try. Definitely 3 or 4 questions will come in the exam on this model. Look at, I will tell another model. So suppose cos inverse cos 95. Tell somebody first what to pick up. Cos inverse cos 95. What to pick up? 95 minus 2n pi or 2n pi minus 95? If so, what? What is the number you have to pick up first? Which one? Tell. What is that one? 95 minus or 95 minus or what is the answer? Tell me. ఎట్లా వస్తుంది ప్యాటర్న్? 95 మైనస్ 12 పై అంటే ఏమి ఏమి ఏం పెట్టాలి? రైట్, 13 పై. వాట్ ఈస్ ద వాల్యూ యూ గాట్ ఫర్ దిస్? జీరో పాయింట్ 77. ఓకేనా? సో లుక్ ఇట్ అమ్మా, 95 minus 35, just pi is 3.142. You get a close value. 30 into this means you will get close. Then try plus this minus or 35 minus. So 95 minus 35 is this. So this is the value between 0 to pi. Now over. So therefore, this I can write as cos inverse cos of 95 minus 35. This, so that means you are, this is x now. So therefore your answer is what? 95 minus 35. Simple. This pattern you remember. No need to try odd multiple. You won't get 2n pi minus 6 or x minus 2n pi. Because for odd multiple of pi, minus x means you will get minus cos x, not cos x. Right, that's why only even multiple. 2n pi minus 6 or x minus 2n pi. These both patterns you have to try. Take some n value, n, 10, 20, 30, like that. Close, pi value you know. You must get close to this 95. So like that cos inverse. Like that cos inverse. Now look at tan inverse tan x. So I told, if x lies between minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2. If x lies between minus pi by 2, open minus 1.57, open to 1.57. Between this and this, if x lies, it is x. If it is not lying between this, then you have to write only one way this. So tan inverse tan x, you have to write in this manner.
tan of
x minus any multiple of pi, any multiple of pi, right? X minus n pi. Look it. If you take 1, tan of x minus pi is what? Suppose tan of x minus any multiple of pi, x minus pi, take minus common. This is what? Tan of pi minus x is what? Minus tan x. If you take x minus 2 pi, then also you will get minus tan of 2 pi minus x, minus of minus tan x. That means pattern of this is x minus any multiple of pi, either even or odd. That means for this pattern you have to remember is x minus n pi. That means you have to try x minus pi, x minus 2 pi, x minus 3 pi, any multiple, even or odd. Provided that value difference is there, that value must lie between minus 1.57 to 1.57. Right? Take one example. Tell somebody what is the pattern I have to pick up for tan inverse tan 12. For tan inverse tan 12, the pattern is 12 minus n pi. You pick up the value. You pick up the value and tell. అందరికీ వస్తుంది, నువ్వు సిగ్నల్ ఆపి మళ్ళీ ఆన్ చేయి వస్తుంది. ఇక్కడ నేను చూస్తూనే ఉన్న వీడియో ఆపి సిగ్నల్ ఆన్ చేయి మళ్ళా. What is the answer?
12 minus, right, very good, 12 minus 4 pi. What is the value? Value 12 minus 4 pi, you will get between, you will get, what is the value? You will get minus 0.568. Correct or not? Minus 0.568. This is lying between minus 1.57. to 1. Even negative also no problem. Negative also no problem. This is a value between this and this only. That means now tan inverse tan of 12 minus 4 pi. You write this as 12 minus 4 pi. That means this is x. Tan inverse tan x, x is the value between this and this. That means your answer is what? 12 minus 4 pi. That is the answer. 12 minus 4 pi. Right, suppose we will try another one. Another one. We will try another one. Look at tan inverse. Who will tell it? I will see. Tan inverse tan. Suppose 2020. First, tan inverse tan 2020. Tan inverse tan 2020, amma. Tan inverse tan 2020. Without doing, don't raise your hand. Immediately after raising hand, you have to answer. What is the answer? Tell. What is that 643? 2643 na? Pi, right? So what is this value you are getting? So minus this means what is the value you will get? This. A minus or plus? Minus how much you will get? 0.306 you will get. So 2020 minus 643 pyra. That means your answer will be simple. Whatever it may be, 0. Only you will get minus 0. Okay, no problem. No, till 1.5 it is allowed. So you can write like this. So tan inverse, this is tan extra. Tan inverse tan x is what? X. So this is your answer. Like that, amma. So sin inverse sin x, what is the pattern? Odd multiple of pi minus x, or x minus even multiple of pi. Cos inverse cos x, what is the pattern? X minus or even multiple of pi, or even multiple of pi minus x. Tan inverse tan x, what is the pattern? X minus any multiple of pi. Like that you have to try, right? Suppose if cot inverse is there, you convert into tan inverse, right? Suppose like this, right? Suppose cot inverse cot 12 is there. Cot inverse cot 12 is there. You convert into tan inverse. So this is what? Tan inverse. This is tan inverse 1 by x tan 12. Just like this. Right? Look at sine. Note the point. Note the point. For sine inverse, cosecant inverse pattern is same. Note the point. Sine inverse, cosecant inverse pattern same. Right? For tan inverse, cot inverse pattern same. For cos inverse, secant inverse pattern same. Same, that formula I told. Sine inverse, what I told? 2n plus 1 pi minus x, or x minus 2n pi. For cosecant inverse, same. Right? For tan inverse, what I told? X minus n pi. For cot inverse also same. Right? For cos inverse, what I told? X minus 2n pi. 2n pi minus x. Right? For secant inverse, same again. Like that. Sin inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse. These three you will ask. Cot inverse is there. You write tan inverse 1 by x. Convert into tan inverse. Then solve the problem. Like that. These patterns. Look at another model. Find values of x for which cos inverse cos 4 greater than 3x square minus 4x, right? So now, look at, I am finding cos inverse cos 4 value. So you will get 4 minus 2 pi m. You have to get between 0 to pi. You will get 2 pi minus 4. Look at 2 pi minus 4. This is a value between 0 to 3.147. That means cos inverse cos 4 is nothing but cos inverse cos of 2 pi minus 4. That means this value is what? 2 pi minus 4. So substitute there. 2 pi minus 4 greater than 3x square minus 4x.
Now you got the quadratic inequality. Quadratic inequality means write like quadratic. Minus 4x plus 4 minus 2pi. Minus 2pi less than 0. It is quadratic inequality. Right? Find the roots for this. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. You won't get factors. Find the roots. 4 plus or minus root of 16 minus. 16 minus 4 into 3, 12. 4 into 3, 12. 12. Divided by 2 into 3, 6. X equal 4 plus or minus root of. Root of. Look at here. 16 minus 48. 16. Minus 48 minus 32 minus 32 plus 24 pi divided by 6. Divided by 6. Now from here 4 take common. 2 will come. 2 cancel both numerator and denominator. That means you will get 2 plus or minus root of 6 pi. 4 into 6, 4 into 8 divided by 3. These are the roots. Here 4 take common and cancel. You will get the roots this one. So what are the roots? 1 is plus, 1 is minus. Take these as roots. Divided by 3. This is smallest root alpha. This is biggest root. This is biggest root beta. Less than 0 means what is the answer? Open alpha comma beta. Open alpha comma beta. That means open. Your solution is divided by 3 comma 2 plus root of divided by 3. This is the solution. This is the solution set. Look at amma. Cos inverse cos 4 I have written. This is the value. I have substituted the value here. I have substituted the value. I got the equation. This bring that side. This is the quadratic equation. Find the roots. I got both roots. One is alpha, one is beta. Alpha is the smallest one, beta is the biggest one. This is less than 0 means what is the answer? X belongs to open alpha comma beta. Quadratic inequalities I told. Less than 0 means open alpha comma beta. Just here difference is you have to calculate this value. The remaining is same. Look at next. Suppose he will ask the problem like this. Look at sine inverse. He is asking cos inverse. Cos x sine inverse cos of
cos inverse cos x plus sin inverse sin x if x belongs to pi by 2 comma pi equals to a pi by 2 b minus pi c pi d minus pi by 2 like this you will ask look at the problem So this cos inverse cos x, sin inverse sin x, this is in this cos. In this cos inside, this complete is there in this cos inside. Right? Now, x belongs to pi by 2 comma pi. Pi by 2 comma pi. Now we will calculate this value. Cos inverse cos x is nothing but what? X. Because this is x when x lies between 0 to pi. Pi by 2 to pi means in between 0 and pi only it is there. Then this is what x. But sin inverse sin x is not x. This value you have to calculate. This is x only. This is in which interval? If x lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. This is x only. When x lies in this interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Now look at here. This I am writing like this. I am multiplying some odd multiple of pi minus x. This sin x I can write like this. Odd multiple of pi minus x. You pick up what to write. Such that this angle where it must lie, this angle minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Now I have written like this. Now check whether pi minus x where it lies. Now look at it. So pi x lies between pi by 2 to pi. Now minus x multiply with minus. If we multiply with minus, inequality interchanges. Multiply with minus. So minus x will be lying between right from this side. Now add pi. This because this where it lies, I have to calculate. Add pi. That means this is 0. Pi minus pi by 2. I have added pi completely. That means if x lies between pi by 2 to pi, where pi minus x lies, it lies between 0 to pi by 2. That means this angle is there. This angle where it is lying, if x is lying between pi by 2 to pi, then this angle is lying in the interval 0 to pi by 2. So therefore this is what? Pi minus x. This is what? Pi minus x. Because this inside angle that is lying between 0 to pi by 2. If this inside angle lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So this is what? This is x. Therefore answer is what? Pi minus x. Now substitute in that. Substitute here. Look at sine inverse cos of this is x, this is pi minus x, this is pi minus x. So x will get cancelled, x will get cancelled. So that means you will get sine inverse cos pi is what? Minus 1. Cos pi is what? Minus 1. Sin inverse minus 1 is what? Minus sin inverse 1. That means minus sin inverse 1 is sin pi by 2. Therefore, minus pi by 2. Minus pi by 2. That is the answer. This is one method.
This is one method. I will tell another method of how to do. Alternate method. Alternate method I will tell you. Alternate method. Look at method 2. Method 2. Just you substitute any x value between pi by 2 to pi, between 90 to 180. 90 to 180, you substitute one value. You substitute one value, 120 degree. Suppose I am substituting 120 degree. In this completely, I am substituting 120 degree. Cos 120 degree is what? Minus 1 by 2. 180 minus 60. Sin 120 is what? Sin 120 is what? 180 minus 60. Root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2. Cos inverse. Cos inverse. Cos 120 minus 1 by 2. Sin inverse, this is root 3 by 2. This is root 3 by 2. This is what I am writing, pi minus cos inverse 1 by 2. Pi minus cos inverse 1 by 2. Sin inverse root 3 by 2. This is cos of, this is cos of, sorry. Sin inverse cos of, inside, cos of, this, now if you look at, sin inverse cos of, pi, this is minus pi by 3, plus, look at here, this is minus pi by 3, this is minus pi by 3, and this is pi by 3. So pi by 3 got cancelled. So sin inverse cos pi. Sin inverse cos pi is what? Minus 1. That means directly you will get. This is minus sin inverse 1. Minus pi by 2. That is the answer. Direct substitution. Direct substitution. Look at, I will explain once again. Between pi to pi, 120 degree is there. 120 degree you substitute here. Cos 120 is what? Minus 1 by 2. Sin 120 is what? Root 3 by 2. Sin inverse cos of cos inverse minus 1 by 2 plus sin inverse root 3 by 2. Cos inverse minus x is what? Pi minus cos inverse x plus sin inverse root 3 by 2. This is pi minus pi by 3 plus pi by 3. Both will get cancelled. What you got? Sin inverse cos pi. Cos pi is what? Minus 1. Minus right outside. Sin inverse 1. Sin inverse 1 means what? Sin inverse sin pi by 2. That means minus pi by 2. This is alternate method. That means if he has given the interval, substitute some value. For that value also you will get the same thing. Minus pi by 2. This is tricky way of doing. That is direct method I told previously. Substitute some value and calculate this value and check the answer. Look at next. Look at. Now we will have whenever tan inverse x. Look at next. Add the tan inverse y. Look at tan inverse x plus tan inverse y.
wherever is there, we have some formula. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. Look at here. Thesis will be there. When x greater than 0, y greater than 0, xy less than 1. Then one formula will be there. Tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. If x greater than 0, y greater than 0, and x into y less than 1, this is the formula. Right? Suppose when x greater than 0, y greater than 0, xy greater than 1, greater than 1, formula is y plus tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Look at, while writing tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, when both are positive, if x greater than 0, y greater than 0, and you product xy less than 1, this is the formula you have to use. If x greater than 0, y greater than 0, xy greater than 1, then use this formula. Right? So this you remember. In tomorrow class, in the ending, I will tell the proof of this. Now remember this formula. How you got tomorrow, I will tell at the end of the class. Okay. So look at how to use the formula is. Okay. Tan inverse 1 by 2. Take one example. Tan inverse 1 by 3. Suppose look at tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. Take first thing as x and other thing as y. And check the conditions. X equal to 1 by 2, y equal to 1 by 3. X equal to 1 by 2, y equal to 1 by 3. So this is greater than 0, this is greater than 0. X into y is what? 1 by 6. X into y is what? 1 by 6. This is what? Less than 1. Less than 1 or greater than 1. So first case, tan inverse x plus y, 1 minus this. So if you simplify this, tan inverse 5 divided by 5. 5 divided by 5. Tan inverse 1. Tan inverse 1 means what? Tan pi by 4. So what is the value? Tan inverse 1 by 2 plus tan inverse 1 by 3 is pi by 4 value. Directly, whenever x is there, y is there. You check x positive, y positive, xy is less than 1 or greater than 1. Right? Here it is what? Less than 1. Less than 1 means first formula. Right? Suppose take another example. Tan inverse 3. Take one example here. Right? Tan inverse 2 plus tan inverse 3. So here x is what? 2 greater than 0. Y is what? 2 greater than 0. 2 greater than 0. So x into y. X into y is what? 6. This is greater than 1. Now this formula, greater than 1. That means pi plus tan inverse. Pi plus 2 plus 3 divided by 1 minus 6. That means pi plus tan inverse minus 1. Pi plus tan inverse minus 1. That means what you will get? Tan inverse minus x is what? Minus tan inverse x. That means this is nothing but pi minus pi by 4. 3 pi by 4. 3 pi by 4. If you have written without this one, you will get wrong answer. Right? So this only we have written instead of pi plus, you will get wrong answer. Right.
So that's why when x positive, y positive, xy greater than 1, write this formula, pi plus. Don't write always tan inverse x plus y by 1 minus xy. Right? Suppose problems will be asked like this. Look at tan inverse, suppose you will ask like this. Tan inverse 1 by 2 plus tan inverse 1 by 5 plus equal to dash. Okay. So first cup 2. This is x, this is y. This is x, this is y. Now clearly x greater than 0, y greater than 0, and x into y less than 1. 1 by 2 into 5 is 1 by 5 is what? Less than 1. So apply formula for the first two. Tan inverse 1 by 2 plus 1 by 5 divided by 1 by 2 into 1 by 5 plus tan inverse 1 by 8. Tan inverse 1 by 8. So that means you will get tan inverse. What you will get here? 5 plus 2, 7 divided by 10 minus 1, 7 by 9. Right? 7 divided by 9 plus tan inverse 1 by 8. Tan inverse 1 by 8. Right? So this is x sum again. This is y. Again 2. So x greater than 0, y greater than 0. X into y is what? 7 by 72. Less than 1. So therefore first formula. First formula again. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. So tan inverse x plus y divided by 1 minus x into y. This. So that means you will get, if you take the LCM, look at 56 plus 9, 65 divided by 72 minus 7, 65. So what you will get? Tan inverse 1, this is what? Pi by 4. Right? Like that, club 2, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. Right? Then club, you will get 1 tan inverse and then club these two. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. Like that, how to use the formula? Look at them. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, the formula that is. Now suppose you got tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. Right? So there is only one case among y greater than 0. X greater than 0. Y greater than 0. XY can be anything. So here XY can be anything among. Only x greater than 0. Y greater than 0. Tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy formula. XY can be anything. So this is the formula. Tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. Always you write this one. X minus y divided by 1 plus xy. For tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, two cases. Suppose like this. Look at tan inverse 1 by 2 minus whenever minus is there, you write like this.
Tan inverse 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 divided by.
Tan inverse, what you will get? Tan inverse, in the numerator, if you take LCM, 3 minus 2, 1. Divided by 6 plus 1, 7. So, tan inverse 1 by 7. That is the answer. Right? If minus is there, always write this formula. Tan inverse x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. If plus is there, two cases. If plus is there, two cases. Look it. Look at, if x greater than 0, look at here. If x greater than 0, look at one point, important point. If x greater than 0, x positive is there in domain. If x greater than 0 in domain, right? Sine inverse x will be what? This value, right? Look at, right? Simple. Sine inverse 1 by 2, what you will get? Pi by 6, positive only. This you will get positive. All we will get positive. Simple, right? X is 1 by 2. Sine inverse 1 by 2 is what? Pi by 6. You will get positive value only. Right? While finding the solutions of a given equation, you remember this. Sine inverse, positive quantity is there inside. Then it will be positive. Right? So, suppose look at sine inverse. Sine inverse, 1 by 1000 is there. 1 by 1000 is there. Whether it is positive quantity or negative quantity, positive quantity. Positive quantity. Right? Remember this one. Right? So, when the inverse function inside positive quantity is there, it will be positive quantity. Right? So, look at finding solutions of given equation. Finding solutions of given equation. Given equation. Look at, one equation will be given and you have to find x value. And you have to find x value. Look at how to solve these type of problems. Suppose one equation I am giving. Look at sine inverse x plus sine inverse 2x equals to pi by 3. Equal to pi by 3. So solve x. Solve x. You have to find x. Look at how to solve the problems is take the angles. Take the angles. Take the angles. Look at. I am taking this angle as A. This angle as A. That means sine A equal to X. Constructing the triangle, look at X 1 root of 1 minus X square. Take this, then sine inverse 2X is B. Take some angle. Sine B is what? 2X. Sine B is what? 2X. I am constructing the triangle. So B, this is 2x, this is 1, this is root of this square minus this square. So 1 minus 4x square. 1 minus 4x square. Now take the equation here. A plus B equals to pi by 3. A plus B equal to pi by 3. Now applies one trigonometric function. I'm applying cos. Both sides, your choice.
1 by 2.
If I apply cos, it will be convenient because roots will be there, that will be eliminated. Right? Cos of a plus b, I have applied on both sides. Cos of a plus b is what? 1 by 2. So from this, I will get an equation in x. Sin a into sin b equal to 1 by 2. Right? I will substitute now values. What is cos a from the triangle? Root of 1 minus x square divided by 1. That is cos a. Cos b is what? Root of 1 minus 4x square divided by 1. Minus what is sin a? X into 2x equal to 1 by 2. What is the benefit of applying is both roots you will get in one term only. If you bring that side and square, root will be eliminated. Right? That is the benefit of applying cos. Now you got this equation. Now I am bringing that side and then squaring on both sides. And then squaring on both sides. So that means bring that side and square. Root of 1 minus x square into root of 1 minus 4x square equals to 2x square plus 1 by 2 whole square. 1 by 2 whole square. This is also square, Amma. This is also square. Square. Right? So look at here. What you will get here? 1 minus x square into 1 minus 4x square equal to 4x power 4 a square plus b square 1 by 4 plus 2 into a into b. 1, 2 will get cancelled. So you will get 4x square. 2 into 2x square into 1 by 2. That means 4x square. Now look at. So here you multiply 1 minus 4x square minus x square plus 4x power 4 equal to 4x power 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 4x square. 4x to the power 4, 4x to the power 4 will get cancelled. Now x square terms one side. So I am bringing 1 by 4 this side. 1 minus 1 by 4, 3 by 4 equals to this 4x square and x square that side. So what you will get? 4x square plus 4x square plus 4x, 9x square. X square 1 minus 5x square 2x square. So this is 7x square. So x square equal to, if you look at 3 divided by 7 into 4. Now x is plus or minus root of, observe carefully, 3 divided by 7 into 4. That means plus or minus root of 3 divided by 28. Now look at two solutions you got. But don't try the answer too without checking. Without checking, don't try both the answers. Now look at, once you got the solutions, you check in the question. Whenever you got the solutions, definitely you must check. Look at pi by 3. So whenever you got the solutions, don't try two solutions. In some cases, some solutions will be wrong. Number one, I will check x. X equal to root of 3 by 28. First minus I am checking that. Minus I am checking. Right? First minus I am checking. I am calculating LHS. Look at LHS. LHS is what you will get, sine inverse minus root of 3 by 28 plus sine inverse 2x. If I substitute this value, this plus this, I have to get pi by 3. Correct or not? So therefore, sine inverse minus is what? Minus. This is minus. I am writing it. If you look at, no need to calculate. This is positive quantity, right? Look at sine inverse. Inside one is what? Positive. Sine inverse value is what? Positive quantity. This is positive quantity. Positive left hand side, positive quantity plus positive quantity. This sum is positive quantity and with minus. So LHS is what? Negative. LHS is what? Negative. Is it clear or not? This is positive quantity. This is no need to calculate. This is positive quantity. This is positive quantity. Sum is positive quantity and with negative sign. So LHS is what? Negative quantity. But RHS is given what? Positive quantity. But RHS is what? Is greater than zero. Can they be equal? They cannot be equal. Therefore, is not a solution. Is not a solution. Because if you substitute, LHS is becoming negative, but RHS is given positive. How can they be equal? Like those type of cases, you can easily judge. After finding solutions, you substitute those values. If you get positive quantity, here positive quantity, then they will be equal. But if you are getting a contradictory case, where you are getting left hand side negative quantity and right hand side positive quantity is given, you can easily check. Just I have substituted. No need to calculate this value. This is positive quantity. This is positive quantity. This is negative. So LHS is negative quantity. LHS is negative quantity. But RHS is given positive quantity. How you will get this value positive quantity? You won't get. Therefore, it is not a solution. Suppose if you substitute x equal to plus 1. X equal to plus 1. X equal to plus 1. So LHS sine inverse this is positive quantity, this is positive quantity. LHS is positive, RHS is also positive. So positive, positive, these values will be equal, right? For this x value, if you calculate this one, this only you will get pi by 3 only. If positive quantity is there, here positive quantity, they can be equal, right? So therefore, this is one solution. This is only solution. X equal to minus solution is wrong. That's why after finding the solutions, what you will do is take that solutions and substitute in the given equation, right? You will get contradictory cases like this, where left hand side is positive, right hand side is negative. So both cannot be equal. You eliminate those. Suppose positive equal to positive you got, then that will be solution only. Those values will be equal only. But negative equal to positive if you get, how can it be the solution? It cannot be solution, right? After finding solution, just check, substitute in the given equation. Okay, Namma, thank you all of you. Have a nice day.